We're here in Maryland at the Patuxent Wildlife Research Center to work with Dr. French as he strives to bring the whooping crane back from the brink of extinction. Now we're going to check in on some new whooping crane chicks.
Okay, what's the plan?
Let's gear up and I'll show you some basics about handling chicks and we'll go check out some babies.
I've been handling chicks all my life.
Not like these. If you're uncomfortable and can't see, you're doing it right.
If I had a nickel for every time I've heard that. It's very,
white.
Yeah. Whose am I wearing?
You're wearing yours, made specially for you.
Karen makes these.
No, you custom made these?
She custom made it for you.
Well, let's just take a moment and drink all this in. Why are we doing this?
Dr. Olson?
We're in these costumes to disguise our human shapes. Secondarily, to sort of look like a white crane, but we don't really look like a crane. But we don't look like humans. That's the main purpose, to keep the chicks from associating with humans when they, after they're released.
Right.
So you can just put our hoods down now, and you can get a good there.
I want to give you a few pointers before we go in there on how to hold the chicks.
Okay.
Rule number one, do not drop the chick.
Don't drop the chick.
Rule two, don't squeeze them too hard.
Don't squeeze the chick too hard. Let's do this.
All right, visors down, voices off, and let's go.
Doctor, what's the official name for this?
Crane costume. Sounds pretty simple, huh?
So you went ahead and focus grouped that?
Yeah.